What's up, everybody? We're here at Staples Center with the Lakers. Have won their sixth straight game. LeBron James, a season-high 40 points, and Mike Trudell. How did it all go down?
Well, LeBron did it so easily and so efficiently tonight, and that made up for a couple of other guys that had uncharacteristically slow shooting nights, like AD, a second straight slow shooting night for him. But it was a night of just spectacular plays, and LeBron had many of them. Many of them were dunks, and I think the first one you think of is the between-the-legs pass from Alex Caruso. LeBron catches the ball, goes up really high, throws it down over Josh Hart, who was kind of trying to get out of the way, at least to a certain extent. So he's scoring inside like that, Joey, and then he also hits five threes. So really had the full complement, and a lot of young guys were making plays. You know, Zion was great, Brandon Ingram was great, Alex Caruso was great, but LeBron was clearly the star of the show.
Yeah, and you know, I really like the way that he dissected the defense tonight. Like you said, he was playing inside, he's playing outside, and he was really doing it at the optimal moments. When Jrue Holiday was switched onto him, he backed him down in the post, really took that point guard deep into the paint, and when they sagged off of him, that's when he hits those five threes. But like you said, Alex Caruso, man, for a guy who had 8 points tonight and 8 assists, I don't want to shortchange our guy.
Yeah,
but for a guy who had 8 points tonight, he had a massive impact. Again, the point plus minus god was out there tonight. What was standing out to you about him?
Yeah, plus 20 for Caruso, and he's just been great. And there's this tendency, I think, now to think of, okay, so Caruso's plus minus has been so amazing. You know, maybe they need to play him X amount more minutes or with different rotations. But you also have to acknowledge that the way that Vogel is using him is allowing him to maximize his time on the court, because sometimes it is coming against bench players on the opponents, and it is also often with LeBron James. And when you put those two together, they're just that much more effective. So yes, you kind of understand that. I know you and I have been advocates for as much playing time for Caruso as possible. But you do have to credit the coaching staff for knowing sort of when to insert him in order to impact the game. Clearly, he's been doing that quite well. And it's fun watching the impact that he makes in this building, too. For as glitzy as people might think the Lakers are, there's a lot of grit, you know, here in this fan base and in this arena, and they appreciate that effort and that energy from Alex, and he clearly rubs off. It rubs off on him, and then kind of vice versa. So it's a nice little marriage between him and the Laker fans.
Yeah, you know, last thing, Mike, bring up the grit. Anthony Davis, 6 blocks tonight, another spectacular defensive game from the potential defensive player of the year. But AC, best block of the season, what do we think?
Man, it's up there. I mean, as you say, best block of the season, it makes me think of a couple of JaVale McGee packs also, like a Terrence Ross cocking one back. He got somebody else too pretty well. AD seems like he's blocking 5 shots a game. But yeah, it was up there, just given the context of it. And Pelicans were kind of on the comeback trail, and that really changed the momentum there. And that's what you want in your blocks, right? You want them to be able to lead to a run on the other end, and that's what the Lakers were able to do.
All right, 3-game road trip coming up. Mike's going to hold it down for us. For Mike, I'm Joey. We'll see you guys later.